and I'm off to an amazing day. It's sunny, it's not so warm now, it's 8:45, and yeah, today I'm going all the way to Arles. It's 65 kilometers and all straight, no height meter or whatsoever. So yeah, let's see how fast I can do it. One problem is there's just one restaurant on the way, so I need to get there by 1 or I won't get anything to eat. Okay, I'm on a way where I can't skate. I just want to tell you that my stomach is okay again. So yeah, no worries. It was just yesterday, my stomach just warned me that I shouldn't eat so much fast food. I'm already walking 2 kilometers on this way. I'm still not by the supermarket, and the way just are horrible right now. I cannot skate at all, so I need to walk and walk. I'm finally on the road again. I'm happy. Oh, it was so tiring. It was just 3 kilometers and it was like half an hour of walking, man. Woo. I just passed by the Lidl and I bought a pain au chocolat and 3 liters of water, so my backpack is now 3 kilos heavier. But I've had the problem, if I don't reach the restaurant on time, there's no water for me until Arles. So I need to buy some water, even if it gets like warm and horrible. I don't care, I need some water to survive this day. I just sat down because it's already been 5 minutes and this train is still passing by. Finally over. I'm out of the big road. I'm now again on a small road. You can't skate here, but it's still safer than going on this big road. So I will walk like the next 5 kilometers or so. I'm pretty sure from the 65 kilometers today, 30 will be walking. Not so nice. When someone like stops and talks to you and asks you what are you doing, where you going, and you tell them, they're like, oh wow, and they ask you, wanna jump on, I take you to the next point, and then you need to say no because, well, you need to push through on your longboard because it's a longboard tour. But yeah, it's kind of funny, I like it. Went completely wrong. I need to turn back some meters and get on the right one. I didn't get the exit. I was too focused on filming. Just check this road out. I'm in the middle of nowhere. It's just a one-way road in the middle of nowhere, and I hope I'm getting to Arles. A guy just told me, I don't know if he was working in the major, that I couldn't go the way Google Maps were telling me. So I'm literally right now, I'm lost, I don't know where to go. So yeah, I will take a break and check on Google Maps where to go. Okay, I'm thinking that the guy told me I'm not allowed to go there because I know that in this area there's a real nice wildlife. So there are white horses, wild, and also bulls. So I do understand why I couldn't go there. I don't see any of them right now, but I'm sure they are there. I just met two older couple, and they told me that they are coming from Arles. And whew, I'm going to Fos-sur-Mer, so basically I'm doing the same way, just in the other direction. Yeah. And yeah, they told me I need to continue here, and then I will get on to a bike lane that will take me all the way to Arles. So I'm guessing that Google Maps is right and it's a good way. So I'm hyped and I'm happy again. And yeah, I'm really looking forward to this bike lane. I hope it's good. Whew. Now I'm on the way that should take me all the way to Arles. And yeah, it's like this bicycle way. Oh well, it's a little road with no cars. And until now it's pretty good, I hope that it continues like that. This river is gonna take me to Arles. It's the same river that's going straight through Arles. So yeah, I'm gonna continue now. And I'm really happy because, I don't know, I'm here alone in the nature. It feels good. This road is so good. It's perfect. Yeah, yeah, I think it's gonna continue like this all the way, not to Arles, but at least halfway until this road ends. Yeah. Woo! I'm so happy. I'm the luckiest guy on this planet. I'm the happiest guy on this planet. Feeling good, feeling really good. Yeah. Love like we did before. Woo! Sign. Literally a sign of a warning that here are bulls. Oh wow, kind of scared. Sunflowers everywhere here, everywhere. There's no been shade in like the last half an hour. I just found a bike lane in the middle of nowhere. Gonna push through. Yeah. Love like we did before. My GoPro still functions. I just fell down. I roll over this hole and my longboard just stuck, and I fell all the way to the front. On one hand I had my GoPro, that's still good, and on the other hand I had my cell phone. Completely broke, it doesn't function at all. Ah, I already disinfected my wounds. Ah, it's mostly my left hand and my right elbow and my right shoulder also hurts. Ah, fuck. And yeah, I disinfected, put some water on. But yeah, I have no idea how I'm gonna continue with all this cell phone. Oh, it hurts and yes. Really nobody. I'm in the middle of nowhere, No possibility to call somebody or whatsoever. I'm definitely on the lowest point of this longboard trip. Definitely. Oh. I just calmed down a little bit. I was really hysterical, really in shock. But I'm good from my wounds and stuff like this. I'm bad because my mobile phone broke. And yeah, now I need to get to the Airbnb without a phone. So my plan right now is to get to Arles. Arles I should do. It's just following this way. And then, I don't know, just follow the road, I think. And then I'm going to go to an electronic place and buy myself a new phone, I guess, because without phone it's quite difficult to get to the Airbnb. And yeah, I will see how I wake up tomorrow. If my shoulder keeps hurting, I will need to go to the doctor. If not, this would be great. My wounds, I disinfected them, so it's no problem. are looking quite good. It's just my left hand and my right elbow. So yeah, nothing on my face. I'm really grateful about that. Nothing on my face. I'm totally good. I will have no problems in the future. And yeah, I will continue now and push through to the supermarket and then to Arles. And yeah, that's my plan right now. And oh man, I also look what I did. I put some sticks in the hall. So the next skater maybe sees it and don't go through there, I don't know. Okay, now I need to be really careful on my way. Really, really careful, because one fall more and I'm out. You know, I'm tired already, it's really hot, and now the fall, I'm really at the lowest point. I mean, I needed like 1 hour just sitting down, relaxing, and just doing nothing, you know, just thinking about life and then getting my motivation back to go on the longboard and get it to Arles. And yeah, good thing is tomorrow free day, so I can rest, and in 2 days it's just a little tour, so it's also okay. And yeah, so I will get to Barcelona hopefully, if I can find a new cell phone. And we are rolling again towards Arles. Yeah, the good thing is my legs are okay, so it's not a problem. And yeah, so I will go slowly and carefully and pass by the supermarket to get something to eat and some shade, you know, some air conditioning. And also pass by the pharmacy to get more desinfection. I don't know if it's called like that. But yeah. It's closed. There's nobody there. They open at 3 o'clock. I'm not quite sure what time it is. I just saw someone in there. But I'm knocking all the time. But they won't open up. Just need this little more of my disinfection spray. I don't know how it's called in English, because mine was really little, so I need some little more, I feel. So yeah, that's why I'm here. A nice lady in the pharmacy just opened up and she helped me. She put on these and also something on my fingers to so it doesn't get infected. It's not my day today, but tomorrow will be again. It's 19 kilometers to Arles. Okay, so I have a long time in front of me and nothing there. I hope this way stays so good so I can really push through. I don't want to go too fast. I think you understand. But yeah, I want to get there. I'm hoping like in 3 hours, and I have no clue what time it is. Is this like 2 o'clock, I would say? Maybe 2 o'clock? Could be. And when I get to Arles, it will be 5. So I have time to get my cell phone, and then it's time to eat something for dinner. I will sit down, eat something while I'm setting up my new phone. And then I'm gonna check out where my Airbnb is. Just 9.2 kilometers to go to Arles. Oh, it feels good. I just pushed 10 kilometers straight through. Oh, it feels so good. I think I'm gonna push again. I wanted to take a break, but now I feel motivated to do it again. And maybe take a break like somewhere there. I'm feeling better now. I really am. I love this way, so nice, awesome. I completely lost the sense of time and space. I have no idea what's the time now. I have no idea where I am. So it feels kind of strange to just skate knowing anything. some very important things to do with Arles. So yeah, that's the bridge from Van Gogh.
Pero tienes que contar en inglés.
Ah, is it in English? Okay, so basically I was walking while I was screaming to my dad why he got mistaken, and all of a sudden I just hear someone calling my name. They were like, Alexander, and I was like, oh my god, I'm famous here in France, someone knows me. And because he looked blonde, I was like, okay, he must be French. But no, it was Kuchenmans.
Yes, it was.
So I was like, how small is the world? And we found ourselves in this beautiful and amazing town, which is called Arles.
Yeah. Alexandra was in our generation in Mexico, in our school, and there's coming a bicycle, yeah?
Yeah.
So it was very funny because it was like sleeping there and I hear Spanish and it was she. And
yes, I know.
And there's coming a car now.
It was surprising, but it was nice. So here we are, small world, right?
Yes.
After I bought my phone, I found Nico, and also he was with a girl from our school and her family, so we went with them to eat and yeah, stuff like that. And yeah, now we're going to our Airbnb. It's 10 kilometers from here, so we need to push through to there.
You're like a runaway, there's something about you, I can't make you stay. Run away, run away.
Woo!
You're like a renegade, something about you, you're always on the move. Renegade, renegade.
We reached the Airbnb. It's a really nice couple who are hosting us, so it's nice. Today wasn't my day. To be fair, today was a really bad day, but I still had fun. I mean, I had fun cruising, and I also had fun then with our classmate, our friend. But well, now I have a new cell phone. It's just sucks, you know. If your cell phone break, I mean that I fall, don't care so much. It's more about my mobile phone. But yeah. See you tomorrow, and yeah, thank you for watching. I hope tomorrow I'm gonna rest, by the way. It's a free day. We took a break, and then the day after tomorrow we're going to Nimes to continue the tour. Yeah, see you then.